Will you hear me when I'm calling? Lord, you catch me when I'm falling, and you taught me who I am. I am yours. Hallelujah.
We need the Lord to make America great again, if indeed we're not going to be raptured right now. Hallelujah. But I believe the Lord's coming soon, brothers and sisters. I believe we're in the last days. I believe this is a great falling away. I believe the rise of the New World Order is very near. And then you have to have a falling away to make that happen. And I believe the rapture is very near. But in the meantime, we don't know that 100%. No man knows the day or the hour. So in the meantime, even if we're only here for one more day, or if we're going to be here for 10 more years, we still need to humble ourselves, carry ourselves as children of God. That we're not citizens of this world. We're citizens of heaven. We're children of the Most High God. We need to carry ourselves that way. Our God makes a way for us. I don't need to fight any battles. God fights the battle for me. You know, there's people like with Antifa and all that. Well, and then the Black Lives Matter. So, well, those people are racist. They want to try to kill me because, you know, they want to kill white people or whatever people think. Or they want to attack Asians and all that, whatever has happened. I believe the Lord's going to protect us. I believe that if, by the grace of God, if I ran into some Antifa people or BLM, which I don't want to, but if I did, I would tell them, you know, the gospel. Instead of, you know, fighting with them, I would say, I'd probably say, I rebuke you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I rebuke that spirit of hate in you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that spirit of communism, of jealousy. It's communism is a jealousy, a covetousness. Communism is covetousness of other people's possessions. So I pray for them to be delivered from those spirits of hate and jealousy and rage and covetousness in Jesus' name. That's what I would do by the grace of God, by the spirit of God. That's my intention to do that. See how I said that? See my intent would be to do it God's way. And by the grace of God, I would do it his way and not, you know, like, okay, let's have a big fight or whatever. Do it God's way, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. By his grace, would not get in the flesh, but do it in the spirit. That's, you got to have that mindset. When you see all the illegal immigrants come across the border, the Lord sees all those people that need to get saved. Yes, it's lawlessness. Yes, they broke the law. Yeah, we know that. And law should be enforced. But as a Christian, well, you know, I'm not in the army anymore. I'm not a policeman. I'm not a, you know, I'm not the governor or whatever. So as a Christian who's not in a political position or military or whatever, and I see illegal immigrants, I want to give them the gospel. So if they get saved, that'll be great because they'll be contributing Christians to wherever, to here, wherever they go to Europe, United States, or wherever they come to. If they get born again. That's great. Hallelujah. There'll be a blessing to this place. Not a bad thing, but a good thing if they truly get saved. And that's what we want. And it's up to the Lord to, you know, to allow us to raise up politicians who will enforce the law. The reason why we have lawlessness is because the Antichrist is called the lawless one. So the spirit of Antichrist is ruling and reigning in most of the earth. And so that is the spirit of lawlessness. So that's why we see lawlessness, brothers and sisters, because that is the spirit of Antichrist. That's what we're seeing. The destruction of the nation state to bring in a one world government. This is all by design at every level. Hallelujah. So we got to see those things for what they are. But we as individuals, see, like I say, Lord provides for me as an individual Christian. And so God would want every individual, even though the big scheme is to fill the country with all these illegal immigrants and Europe too, to collapse the West and bring in the New World Order, create chaos and famine and pestilence and civil war and all that. They want all that stuff. Divide and conquer everybody so they can bring in a new world order, Tower of Babel thing. That's what they want. All your neighbors are from different countries, different languages, different religions, Tower of Babel. But my individual job as a Christian is to try to win those people to the Lord. The devil's doing his thing, and then I'm going to try to do God's thing. And then it's up to the Lord to figure out all those things. And the politicians ain't going to save us. If we all humble ourselves and pray, then the Lord would send a great awakening. Millions and millions of people get saved, and then the politicians would get in there that were also godly, law-abiding, godly people, then it would turn it all around. That's the only way. It's not by some, you know, by force. You can't force morality on these wicked people. Look how wicked these people are today now in the West. Bunch of neo-pagans got their ears gauged out like this and all this freak show looking tattoos on their faces and looking like demons and all the transgenderism and all that stuff. I mean, it's beyond. It's not. There ain't no law going to stop that. I mean, this is just a evil. It's pure evil. This at every level, brothers and sisters. Neo-paganism is what it is. It's back to the ancient days before Christianity. As I mentioned before, Rabbi Condes wrote a book about that, and it really is totally, You know, the Lord had led me to listen to him. I don't listen to many people. He was saying that the return of the gods, the ancient gods, you know, Baal and all that, that's absolutely what it is. The return of the ancient false gods before Christianity. All those things, those temples of Zeus and all that, they've got wiped out when Christianity took over the world, brothers and sisters. Now all that stuff is coming back because Christianity has retreated because of the great falling away. So the vacuum, there's a spiritual vacuum when there's not many Christians. And that's what opens the door for all those, like in Europe, all those people from the Middle East going up there with a different religion. If there was a bunch of Christians there, the Spirit of the Lord would be blessing all those Christians and the angels would be there and those people wouldn't be coming up there because there would be this hedge of protection around all those Christians, but there ain't that many Christians. Same thing with America. We wouldn't have all this crime and lawlessness if we had a lot more Christians who were praying and being salt and light, and we would have a hedge of protection, a blessing on us. Even look now, look at the Bible Belt states in America. Look at Texas, look at Florida, the southeastern part of the United States, and then go look at the northeastern part. Look at the dictator governors with the mandates. Look at the level of sickness versus the South. Look at the liberty and freedom in the Bible Belt versus other parts of the country, brothers and sisters. This is all a result of the blessings of God because there's more Christians there. It's just so simple and so obvious now. If you can't see it, I don't know what to tell you. You got to pray about it. You got to look. Open your eyes and see. Hallelujah. God blesses his people. Hallelujah. So the more Christians you have, the more blessing there's going to be in that place. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Where the Spirit of the Lord's giving me a witness Bible verse. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. So that's why when I see videos in these countries like Scotland, UK, where they beat down people, people go in the store and they beat you down and arrest you and lock you up because you won't put on a face diaper. You see that a bunch all over these godless. You know, the highest percentage of atheists anywhere in the United States is Rhode Island. The lowest percent of Christians anywhere in the United States is the Northeast. So you see the most corruption, the most stuff going on in those areas. He's got the more godless areas you go to, higher taxes, more corruption. It all goes hand in hand, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah.
For as the lightning comes from the east and flashes to the west, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming.
John 3:3. Jesus answered and said to him, "Most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God."